Today we'll be demonstrating how to assemble a Baumann 84,000 sanitary valve. These valves are designed to satisfy the stringent demands of the pharmaceutical and biotechnology industries. First, we'll start with the bonnet assembly. An O-ring is used to seal around the piston stem at the top of the bonnet. Make sure that there are no tears or breaks in the O-ring before installing it, and lubricate the O-ring with a sanitary-grade grease. The piston stem subassembly comes from the factory already assembled. However, there are variations of the piston that allow for different rates of flow. Make sure you have the proper piston assembly and then carefully insert it into the bonnet. Turning the stem as it's inserted through the O-ring will help to minimize damage. The piston works with a drive mechanism which moves a compressor. The bottom rollers, which interface with the compressor plate, extend past the body of the drive mechanism. This is how to tell the top rollers from the bottom rollers. Install the drive mechanism into the bonnet over the wedge end of the piston and be sure to push the two bottom rollers open as far as possible. The compressor is installed over the drive mechanism and the diaphragm will attach directly to the compressor after the bonnet assembly is complete. The rollers from the drive mechanism move across the compressor, which will move the diaphragm to open and close the valve. To finish the compressor mechanism assembly, 2 to 3 wave springs, depending on the size of the valve, are installed. The springs should be installed so that the split in the springs are offset by 180 degrees. A retaining ring is installed to hold the springs in place. The final component in the bonnet assembly is the plug for the telltale leak port. Apply some sanitary grade grease to the threads and install that. With the bonnet assembly complete, it's time to install the diaphragm and attach the assembly to the valve body. When installing the diaphragm, you must first install an O-ring, which helps protect the diaphragm from wearing against the bonnet on 1.5 and 2-inch valves only. Sanitary grease should be applied to the O-ring as well as the threads and back of the diaphragm. Push the piston into the closed position so that the compressor is extended as far as possible from the bonnet assembly. Then the diaphragm itself is threaded directly onto the compressor plate. Be very careful not to deform the diaphragm by over-tightening it. A good rule for installing the diaphragm is to tighten it to firm contact with the compressor plate, then back it off a quarter turn. With the O-ring and diaphragm in place, the entire assembly can be added onto the valve body. Clamps or a flange are used to attach the bonnet to the body. Make sure you tighten everything evenly to ensure the diaphragm is evenly sealed between the bonnet and body to create an aseptic barrier. That completes the assembly procedure for a Baumann 84,000 valve. Visit Fisher.com to learn more about this and other Baumann products. Thanks for watching.